This tutorial shows how to create external hyperlinks in Microsoft Word. Hello, my name is Erin. I'm a technical writer and editor who shares step-by-step software tutorials and writing tips for the real world on this channel and on my blog at erinwrightwriting.com. Today's tutorial shows how to create external hyperlinks in Microsoft Word. Specifically, we'll create links to separate files, websites, and email addresses. We'll also look at how to edit or remove hyperlinks. Lastly, we'll go through the steps to turn off automatic hyperlinking in Word. Please note that we will change the style of hyperlinks and create internal bookmarks in separate Word tutorials. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. The steps are the same for Word 2019, Word 2016, Word 2013, and Word 2010. However, your interface might look slightly different in those older versions of the software. To begin creating your hyperlink, select the text or image you want to turn into a hyperlink. After you've made the selection, there are several ways you can access the link option. You can select the Insert tab in the ribbon and then select the Link button. Or PC users can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl plus K. Or you can right-click the selected text or image and then select Link from the shortcut menu. That's the method I'm going to choose today. When the Insert Hyperlink dialog box appears, select Existing File or Web Page if you want to link to another file or a website. If you want to link to a separate file, locate and then select the file in the Look In section. The file name will appear in the address text box after you make your selection. Remember that your readers will only be able to open the file you are linking to if it's stored in the location they can access, such as a shared server or cloud storage. If you want to link to a website, enter the URL including the HTTPS or HTTP in the address text box. If you want to link to an email instead, choose Email Address, and then enter the address in the email address text box. It's important to note that when you start typing, Word will automatically insert mail to colon before the address. This term is required to open the email link, so use caution not to delete it. You can then enter a subject into the subject text box, although that's not required. To add a screen tip, select the Screen Tip button. A screen tip is a short piece of text that appears when your readers hover their cursor over the link. Screen tips should be used to tell your readers the link destination so they aren't surprised when they click the link. By default, Word will add the file name, web address, or email address as the screen tip. However, you can enter more specific text into the Set Hyperlink Screen Tip dialog box. When you're finished, select the OK button. And then select the OK button to close the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. Your text or image should now be converted to a hyperlink. To follow a hyperlink in Word, press the Control key on your keyboard while selecting the link. Now we're going to look at how to edit or remove hyperlinks. If you want to edit the hyperlink, right-click it and then select Edit Hyperlink from the shortcut menu. Next, edit the link in the Edit Hyperlink dialog box. Select the OK button when you're finished. If you want to remove the hyperlink from the text or image, again, right-click it and then select Remove Hyperlink. The link should be removed from the text or image immediately. Word will automatically create a hyperlink to any full web address or email address typed in your document. To remove a hyperlink, you can right-click it and select Remove Hyperlink, as we did in the previous section. However, you can stop Word from creating links by turning off automatic hyperlinking. To begin, select the File tab in the ribbon, followed by the Options tab in the Backstage view. Next, select the Proofing tab in the Word Options dialog box. From there, select the Autocorrect Options button. When the Autocorrect dialog box appears, select the Auto Format as you type tab, and then uncheck the Internet and Network Paths with Hyperlinks option. Once that's unchecked, select the OK button, and then select the OK button to close the Word Options dialog box. Word should no longer automatically create hyperlinks in your document. As always, remember to save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to create bulleted lists in Microsoft Word and how to create and update a table of contents in Microsoft Word. Please see the playlist titled How to Use Microsoft Word, which is linked below for the complete list. The companion blog post for this video showing all the steps we just performed appears on erin.writewriting.com, which is also linked below. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic related to Microsoft Word, Adobe Acrobat, or Google Docs that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials, and give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.